Good morning, everyone. Today is the fifth Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our presider is Father Gregory Kirsch. Do we have anyone visiting today? We have a visitor. A special welcome. Thank you for joining us. And please turn to those near you, greet them, introduce yourselves if you don't already know them, make them feel welcome. And if you haven't already, please silence your cell phones. Cell phones off, please. And open with number 562, Sing of the Lord's Goodness. Number 562. Please stand.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father, the love of the Lord Jesus, and strength of the Holy Spirit be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we enter into the mysteries of God's love this Sunday, in a special way we're praying for our confirmandes, those who are sitting in the front of our church today, as they are preparing for a day of retreat, to prepare them for the gift and sacrament of confirmation. So we as a larger community hold you in prayer and pray that your retreat will be a time of pause, reflection, and growth. Get to know each other and also prepare for this gift of the Holy Spirit. And Father Ramon, our pastor, is going to inflame us today with an opportunity of how we may consider the many gifts we've been given. So as we enter into prayer on this Sunday, let us acknowledge our sinfulness, trusting in God's mercy and love.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
You came to call sinners. Christe eleison. At the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Kyrie eleison.
Kyrie eleison.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
For you.
Let us pray. Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
We invite our children, preparing for the children's liturgy of the word, to come forward at this time. With this book of God's word, we commission you, in the name of the Lord Jesus, to share with our children the story of God's unfailing love and remind them of our deep concern with you as they grow in grace and love. Go in peace.
Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, share your bread with the hungry, shelter the oppressed and the homeless. Clothe the naked when you see them, and do not turn your back on your own. Then your light shall break forth like the dawn, and your wound shall quickly be healed. Your vindication shall go before you, and the glory of the Lord will answer. You shall cry for help, and he will say, here I am. If you remove from your midst oppression, false accusation, and malicious speech, if you bestow your bread on the hungry and satisfy the afflicted, then light shall rise for you in the darkness, and the gloom shall become for you like midday. The word of the Lord. Everlasting remembrance and evil remembrance.
darkness shall endure forever. His horn shall be exalted in glory.
Letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. When I came to you, brothers and sister, proclaiming the mystery of God, I did not come with sublimity or words of wisdom, for I resolved to know nothing while I was with you, except Jesus Christ and him crucified. I came to you in weakness and fear and much trembling. And my message and my proclamation were not with persuasive words of wisdom, but with demonstration of spirit and power, so that your faith might rest not on human wisdom, but on the power of God. The word of the Lord.
Its taste, with what can it be seasoned? It is no longer good for anything but to be thrown out and trampled underfoot. You are the light of the world. A city set on a mountain cannot be hidden, nor do they light a lamp and then put it under a bushel basket. It is set on a lampstand, where it gives light to all in the house. Just so, your light must shine before others, that they may see your good deeds and glorify your heavenly Father. My brothers and my sisters, the Gospel of the Lord. Jesus Christ uses parables in order for the people in his time, and even today, we can get a good grasp of what he means when he proclaims the gospel to us. He uses two important elements in the world today that everyone should know. The first one is salt, and the second is light. Salt is important, and we have many uses of salt. Even before we had refrigerations, salt was there. And what was it? It brings flavor, it preserves, and it brings flavor and goodness to all. And we know very well that if salt has no flavor, it is good for nothing. Light, we have been so accustomed that every time we come to church, the light is there, and we, of course, expect it to be bright so that we can read. Am I right? And yet, just imagine if a lamp is put under a bushel basket, what good is it? It will not be able to dispel the darkness. We are all followers of Jesus. And now it is our responsibility to dispense the darkness that we encounter around us. Because we are the light of Christ, the light that dwells within each and every one of us. Isaiah the prophet makes it very clear. In fact, the very first words in the first reading, share your bread with the hungry, shelter the oppressed and homeless, clothe the naked when you see them, and do not turn your back against your own. These, my brothers, are all concrete ways in which we flavor, we preserve on this earth God's goodness and allow light to dispel the darkness. Each of us has the opportunity to glorify God according to our gifts, our circumstances, our own state in life. Even if what we can only offer is a grain of salt or perhaps a flicker of a match light, that's okay. Whatever we have been given by God, it is meant to be shared for the life of the world. Whatever we have is worth giving. St. Paul says in the second reading that our faith might not rest on human wisdom, but on the power of God, that we may be salt of the earth and the light of the world. This introduces us into the theme of our Together in Mission 2020. Our story is alive. Yes, my dear brothers and sisters, what is that story we are talking about? It is our own faith, what we profess as Catholics, what we believe as Catholics. That story continues to be alive. And today, on this Commitment Sunday for Together in Mission, our parish has been given the goal of 93,064. And what does that mean for us? That this story, if we can allow that to be alive among our brothers and sisters, it reminds us that our gifts to Together in Mission will open the doors of 67 parishes and 74 schools. Their doors will be open for a year for ministry. And because we are the salt of the earth, the light of the world, we make that story come alive in all these people in our archdiocese. We need to bring about the love of Christ in each and every one of them. So at this time, I like to invite one member of each family to take an envelope like this one that I have in my hand to fill up the pledge for commitment to Together in Mission. Let me remind you that if you have already received a letter in the mail from the office of Together in Mission, you do not need to fill another one unless you want to do so. Confirmation students, make sure you look back and you give a sign to mom and dad to fill up this envelope. So if you need more, there are views. There are envelopes in your respective views. You may raise your hand if you need one, so that our confirmation students will give you one. And now I'd like to help you fill up this envelope. If you open the flip cover of that, right here is the pledge envelope that I would like to fill up with you at this time. Let me be honest with you, it's very hard to read it. It is printed in tiny letters. And yet, I will be here to explain to you what this is all about. If you open the envelope, there is a pencil inside this envelope that we will use in writing the data that we need to fill it up. So on the top, the first line in this envelope, please print your first name, and if you are married, the first name of your spouse, and then next to that is your last name. The next two lines are important because that's where you will print your correct address, not the address of your neighbor, but your correct address, the city, and the zip code. Next line underneath that is we ask you to please fill up your email address, your telephone number, and beside that telephone number, there are two boxes there. Please indicate whether it's a home phone or it is a mobile or a cell phone. The line underneath that is very important, and that's the name of your parish. If you forgot the name of our parish, it's St. John Baptist de La Salle. Please make sure you write it down there. If you want the abbreviation, you can also do that. SJDBLS. So that your donation will be credited to our parish. Underneath that are three boxes, small boxes. The first one is, if you are making a pledge today, please check that box. And then the next two is, are you giving a cash gift or a check payable to Together in Mission? Underneath that is, if you are able to remember your credit card number, then you will put it there, or if you brought it with you, then you can fill that up underneath this. And now I want you to move to the right side of this pledge envelope. On that right side, it tells you a suggested pledge. It's a suggestion. There are 1, 2, 3, 4. And on the fifth is an empty line. So please look at what number is familiar to you. If you want to go down to the empty line, because I see a number there. It's invisible, but I don't know why I can see it. You know what I see? 1,000,000. That's what I see there. Brothers and sisters, it is a suggested pledge. It's a suggestion. And underneath that, please indicate the total of your pledge on that line. And if you are giving a cash today, subtract that from the total, and underneath, you will put the balance. If you are using a check, please write the check number underneath that. Once you have completed this envelope, please do not reinsert the pencil inside, because we are going to use those pencils again in the next masses. But go ahead and seal this envelope And our confirmation students who are here will collect that. If you would pass it towards their side so that they will collect those envelopes. Once again, in behalf of Archbishop Jose Gomez and all the 67 parishes and 74 schools who are beneficiaries of Together in Mission, I wish to thank you for your generous support and for your continued support for Together in Mission. Somebody asked me, Father Ramon, what's the difference between Together in Mission and Called to Renew? A very, very big difference. Together in Mission is the operating cost for 1 year to run ministries in 67 parishes and 74 schools. If we help them, they will be open for ministry. Called to Renew is the maintenance of parishes, and we look forward to a longer time to support all these parishes. And that's why Call to Renew is 5-year commitment. Together in Mission is a 1-year commitment. So you can make one installment, 5 installments, or 10 installments. So once again, thank you for making our story alive in all these parishes and schools, and in our brothers and sisters in the Archdiocese of Los Angeles. Thank you, and may God bless all of you.
Our community of faith, dear candidates and catechumens, now send you forth to reflect more deeply upon the word of God which Father Ramon has broken open for us. As we send you forth, be assured of our loving support and prayers for each of you, your family and friends, as we accompany you in the journey to fullness, when soon you will share with us at the table of the Lord. May the Lord remain with you now and forever. Go in peace and be assured of our prayers as you grow in faith. Thank you.
Take the word of God with you as you go. Take the seeds of God's word and make them grow. Go in peace to serve the world, in peace to serve the world. Take the love of God, the love of God with you as you go.
Let us profess our faith together using the Apostles' Creed on page 10, page 10. It will also be projected on the screens to help us. So the Apostles' Creed on page 10. Together we pray. I believe in God. I confident that God hears us, we present the needs of our community.
For missionaries who bring the light of the gospel to distant lands, may they be blessed with the spirit of wisdom. Let us pray. For civic leaders, governments, and international bodies, and for all who seek an increase in charity throughout the world, let us pray. For those who have no voice, may the Lord grant them a stronghold of faith and advocates to defend them. Let us pray. For this community of believers, may God be our guide as we seek to be his salt and light for the world. Let us pray. For those who have died, may they be embraced this day by the light of Christ, especially DJ Bennett, Julie De La Vega, Dennis Vigil, Eduardo Gonzaga, Jessica Vroden, and the De La Salle parishioners for which this Mass is offered. Let us pray. For all those intentions that we hold in our hearts, and for all those remembered in our parish book of prayer, let us pray.
And let us pray for all victims of violence or abuse, for an end to this harm against the human family, and for those who perpetrate abuse or violence to stop, we pray. Gracious and loving God, as we gather on this Sunday, you remind us that we are the salt of the earth and the light of the world. Help us with courage to be these forces in the world to bring about your love and your justice through Christ our Lord. my sisters and brothers, that our gifts, our sacrifices, may be acceptable to our loving and merciful God.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his church.
Lord our God, who once established these created things to sustain us in our frailty, grant, we pray, that they may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For you laid the foundation of the world, and you have arranged the changings of times and seasons. You formed us in your own image, and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, forever praising you in your mighty works, through Christ our Lord. And so with angels and archangels, and in joyful celebration, we acclaim. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, once more giving thanks, handed the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Lord, remember your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis our Pope, Jose our Bishop, and all your people. Remember also our sisters and brothers who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the apostles, the martyrs, John Baptist de La Salle, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to pray. Our deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we wait in joyful hope for the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sin, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other the sign of God's peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of our world. Blessed and happy are we who are called to share in the banquet of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word.
Number 725, blessed are they. Number 725.
The kingdom of God.
Number 337, Behold the Lamb, 337.
Thank you.
Let us pray. O God, who have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and the one chalice, grant us, we pray, so to live that, made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Well, have a wonderful Sunday, and please pray for all the confirmandis and their retreat guide. That's me today, so pray that we all have a wonderful retreat, okay?
Yeah.
Yay! For their sponsors and parents and all of their teachers and catechists along the way, because they've been instrumental in bringing this day together. So know that you're being prayed for and held with great esteem. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thanks be to God. Number 591. We are the light of the world. 591.
Because we